morning, dear students of class 12. Welcome to the English online learning class. Today, we are going to further continue with the lesson Ivan tries an O level. But before we take up the lesson part 8, let us quickly revise what we did in part 7. So, Ivan, who had a notorious record of breaking jail 3 times, was housed in Oxford prison. And the reason being that there were some northern disturbances which wanted that for the time being, Ivan should be kept in prison. Now, Ivan in Oxford prison expressed desire to learn German language, and he also wanted some kind of academic qualification. So he was provided with a private tutor, and also he expressed his desire to appear in the exam. So governor sought permission from the secretary of examination to allow Ivan to appear for the exam in the prison in his cell. Modalities of exams were chalked out. There was a small sort of inquiry gathering by the secretary who wanted what sort of a person was Ivan. So the governor disclosed information which would be beneficial for granting permission. Like he was a pleasant chap and he's suffering from a congenital disease. He's a kleptomaniac. He has many qualities. He's a star of concerts. But he did not disclose one information, and which was that Ivan's had a track record of breaking jail 3 times. Because this aspect, the governor thought he's going to take care of himself. The reputation of Oxford prison, his own reputation was at stake. Now, all the security arrangements were tightened. The senior officer Jackson, junior officer Stephens were specially deployed to monitor the security arrangements, and the governor would be supervising everything. So, on the day of the exam, McClary, who was the invigilator, he started from his apartment and he reached Oxford prison. Now, there were many lapses which we have already discussed in the previous classes. As the lesson progresses also, you will find many lapses which Ivan takes advantage of. So, last minute, when McClary had entered the cell, he was asked to come out. His things were searched. And one thing was very puzzling, why he was carrying the rubber ring. But even that was permitted because he said that he has a problem of hemorrhoids. The paper knife which he was carrying was taken. Now, during exam, Ivan wanted first Stephens to go out of the cell, but Stephen would be maintaining close watch through the peephole, and he also wanted a blanket because it was cold. It was given because genuinely that part of the cell was cold, and the governor received 2 phone calls. One was from the additional secretary of board examination, saying that there was a correction slip which was forgotten to be put in the envelope, and for this the governor connected him to the Ivan's prison, and he also suspected initially, but later he permitted. He tried to check up with the secretary, but the phone call was not received as it was engaged. Then he himself checked and found that the corrections were being made, as the governor himself knew a little bit of German. And he felt bad for Ivan's. Probably he thought that would he be able to do the paper properly or not. Then The magistrate's office also wanted the governor to send prison van and prison officers. Governor initially suspected, but he thought that work could not go on like this. So the exam was delayed because some last minute decisions of asking McCleary to come out had to be taken. And then finally, the exam started. No untoward incident happened, and the exam came to an end. Stephen was asked by the governor to escort McCleary to the prison gate. Now, we'll continue part 8. How did he get on, do you think? So, Stephen is asking McCleary, asked Stephens as he walked beside McCleary to the main gates. Oh, I cannot think he's a distinguished himself, I'm afraid. So, the invigilator says, I'm afraid that he has not done very well. His Scots accent seemed broader than ever, and his long black overcoat reached almost to his knees, fostered the illusion that he had suddenly grown slimmer. This is what Stephens thought, that he's overdoing his Scots accent. And his black overcoat is also reaching his knees, which gave him the feeling that he has grown suddenly slimmer. Stephen felt pleased that the governor had asked him and not Jackson. This duty was assigned by the governor to Stephens and not to Jackson. So Stephen was feeling very important as he was newly recruited in the profession. To see McCleary off the premises and all in all, the morning had gone pretty well, so everything was fine. But something stopped him from making his way directly to the canteen for a belated cup of coffee. Now he badly needed coffee to relax himself. He wanted to take just one last look at Evans. Before leaving for the canteen for a cup of coffee, he thought that he should go and check in Evans' cell. It was like a program he had seen on TV. He remembered a program that he saw on TV. It was about a woman who could never really convince herself that she'd locked the front door when she'd gone to bed. Often she got up 12, 15, sometimes 20 times to check the bolt. So this woman was not sure, and she used to get up from bed and check whether she had bolted the door, say, many times, 12, 15, and sometimes 20 times. So he thought that his condition is like that old woman. He re-entered D wing, made his way along to Ivan's cell, and opened the peephole once more. Oh no, Christ, no. There, sprawled back in Ivan's chair, was a man. For semi-second, Stephens thought it must be Ivan's. A grey regulation blanket slipping from his shoulder, the front of his closely cropped, irregularly tufted hair awash with fierce red blood, which had dripped already through the small black beard and was even now spreading horribly over the white clerical collar and down into the black clerical front. So, the invigilator was there and he was badly bleeding. Evans was nowhere to be found, and he had escorted the invigilator to the prison gate after the exam. Stephen shouted wildly for Jackson, and the words appeared to penetrate the curtain of blood that veiled McCleary's ears, for the minister's hand fell feebly for a handkerchief from his pocket and held it to his bleeding head, the blood seeping slowly through the white linen. He gave a long, low moan and tried to speak, but his voice trailed away, and by the time Jackson had arrived and dispatched Stephens to the ring, to ring the police and ambulance, the handkerchief was sticky, squelchy wadge of cloth. So Stephen immediately called for Jackson, and Jackson asked Stephens to ring the police and the ambulance because McCleary was injured and he had to be taken to the hospital. We'll stop here and we'll continue with the remaining in the next class. Thank you.